Let's rock on the mic. What's up, everybody, and you are listening to the best of the Media Mike Radio Show. I am your host, the Media Mike Speaks, sponsored by New Justice Media, where we are the voice of the everyday citizen. The time is now 11 minutes past the hour here in the Lone Star State, so let's get to it before it's too late. All right, good people, I'm pretty sure by now, you know I'm back, so been going a while, actually out of the country, and been flooded with a lot of your emails and text messages and articles, and I have a lot of catching up to do. And I want to start with this story. As we all know, social media has dramatically changed our lives in the last 10, 15 years. From Facebook, from the old MySpace, now we have Instagram. You know, it's going at a almost at the speed of sound, I would say. But I want to bring this to your attention here. For those of you who have elderly parents or uncles, aunts, things like that, you know, we'll talk about that a little bit more. Be careful. And not just the elderly, but regular people too. But right now, we're going to talk about the elderly. It's nothing new. See, before we had the internet, we had the landline telephone, which still exists today. And we had, you know, the television set, which still exists today. And people would come on the television and your elders would be at home because either they're too sick to go out or they're retired. And they would look at TV and they would call 1-800 numbers. They would have them give for some charitable cause, which may or may not be legitimate, you know, or people would call their phone and they would tell them things and they would get scammed. So it's nothing new. But today, we have Instagram, Facebook, we have cyber, we have a computer, laptop, phone, iPad, watch, whatever it is you want to call it. This woman, Mona Montrage, or Montrage as she goes by, she had a lavish lifestyle of designer outfits, shopping trips, and overseas travel on social media. To her 4.2 million Instagram followers, she's a musician and a mogul who jet sets between the Canadian capital of Accra and London. Now, she's from Ghana. I would say Ghanaian. But a federal indictment unsealed alleges that she was part of a cybercrime organization from West Africa that committed a series of scams, including romance scams, which bilked over $2 million from older and vulnerable Americans. Now, it doesn't take a rocket scientist to know that most of these probably were men, older men, past their prime, looking for one more chance at the brass ring. She was arrested in the United Kingdom and was extradited to New York, according to federal officials. Now, this woman faces various charges, including conspiracy to commit wire fraud, money laundering, and conspiracy to receive stolen money, according to the U.S. Attorney's Office of the Southern District of New York. Now, I'm going to tell you how they caught her. We'll get to how they caught her. And I'm going to give you my two cents. And I do believe how she got caught, other than her name, giving her real name. But yeah. Now, she pleaded not guilty. And her attorney, Adam Cortez, told CNN in an email he declined to comment further, saying he's still awaiting more details on the allegations from the government. This is a government crime, people. Serious crime here. She allegedly convinced one victim they were married. Now, this woman is 30 years old. Now, once again, she's allegedly part of a group of con artists from West Africa. Now, I don't know who this victim is who thought they were married. really, we'll get to that in a second too, how I feel about stuff like that. I told you it's the internet, and somehow you think what is not real is real. Now, between 2013 and 2019, their criminal enterprise allegedly committed various forms of fraud against individuals and companies in the United States. The alleged crimes included romance scams that preyed on older men and women who lived alone, according to court documents. Now, she's part of a group, a ring, you know, we're talking RICO. I would say RICO charges. Yes. They didn't say that in here, but why not? I don't see where the RICO charges here. And it did mention women, but right now, this is focused on her. Now, I don't know. Well, hey, we're in the woke culture today, so maybe. I don't know. But mainly, I think this was mostly men. Now, if there were multiple parties involved, it could be other men. It could be men who preyed on older women. Now, federal prosecutors detailed scams that they said left victims financially and emotionally devastated. What are you getting on your return? You're not even actually physically seeing the person. I mean, being with them. They're on there and okay. The internet has brought out a lot of things about people that we did not know. Would I say that a lot of people are fundamentally stupid? Yes. Now, these scammers allegedly reached out to the victims through online dating and social media apps. They used fake identities to send texts, emails, and social media messages and duped them into believing they were romantically involved, court documents say. I just, this is a one-sided relationship, but in defense of some of the victims, you have a lot of lonely people out there who just don't want to go out anymore. Okay. So, once members of the enterprise had successfully convinced victims that they were in a romantic relationship, how can you successfully convince somebody that you have not even physically seen and had gained their trust? How? They convinced the victims under false pretenses to transfer money to bank accounts the victims believed were controlled by their romantic interests, when in fact the bank accounts were controlled by members of the enterprise, according to the indictment. Wow. Ms. Montrage controlled bank accounts that received over $2 million in fraudulent funds, according to the indictment. She had accounts in New York and elsewhere, where some of the funds were deposited, and she dispersed them to other scammers who she was working with, according to court documents. In one instance, she allegedly used her real name, and that's bingo how they got her, to communicate with the victim by phone and receive money directly from the victim. She tricked the victim into believing that they were officially married, court documents said. That's how they got her. Strike one. They got her by the real name. Now that was on her. Dummy dumb dumb. Now, Ms. Montrage sent the victim a tribal marriage certificate purporting to show that Montrage and the victim had been married in Ghana, court documents said. So, I guess this is by proxy. You don't have to be there. And you really don't, you know, in certain cases, but at least, you know, like, but you do know who you're with. Like, these things do happen, but y'all have been together. Y'all have been together physically. You've been together, and then you may not be able to make it, and then they... But this is like, I've never even physically touched you. You just, we talk on the phone, maybe you just, this is bad. Now, she allegedly convinced the victim to send her $89,000 through 82 wire transfers for her father's farm in Ghana. $89,000. Who is she targeting? These are people that stacked. It seems they got it like that. And in November 2018, she allegedly received checks worth at least $195,000 from another romance scam victim, according to the indictment. Oh, my gosh. Now, this woman, Montrage, she's charged with one count of conspiracy to commit wire fraud, and one count of wire fraud, and one count of money laundering conspiracy, and one count of money laundering, each of which carries a maximum sentence of 20 years in prison, according to the Department of Justice with the RICO. She's also charged with one count of receipt of stolen money, which carries a maximum sentence of 10 years in prison, and one count of conspiracy to receive stolen money, which carries a maximum sentence of 5 years in prison, according to the DOJ, Department of Justice. Now, is she going to do all of this? No. I think she's going to cry and claim she's not the mastermind and point the fingers. If she's working with other people, which most likely she probably is, she's going to go ahead and turn all of them in. And she may get some time, maybe probation, maybe 5 years, 3 years, and has to return all this money. Now, her bail is set at $500,000, $500,000, and once she's released, she'll be on home detention and subjected to electronic monitoring at her aunt's house in New Jersey. Wow. Now, people, this is, for one, really sad, and for those who have been victimized. Now, part of me, as I stated earlier, want to just, I don't know. I'm not going to say it because, but I'll tell you toward the end how I really feel about this. Because I do believe that there were, I really want to call these people, mainly men, idiots. Now, we know the old saying, there's a sucker born every minute. Well, in this case, that reigns to be true due to the fact how technology moves these days. Now, my thoughts on this, that she, Miss Montrage, seriously pissed off the wrong person, I do believe. I mean, to be charged in, I think, what, two, three different countries? The U.S., United Kingdom, and Ghana? Who did Miss Montrage piss off? Must have been someone very powerful, enough to get the attention of the feds. Now, people, like I just said, look, romance scams are growing. The report states that they take a $1.3 billion loss over a period of time. So last year, they took $1.3 billion losses last year. They're one of the fastest growing types of fraud, according to the FTC, Federal Trade Commission. And it's romance scams, including cryptocurrency and gift cards. Just people are paying these people that. This stuff is growing at a rapid rate. Protect your elders, mothers, fathers, uncles, aunts, and so forth. And most of all, protect yourself. So what do y'all think will happen to this woman? Like I told you, I don't think she's going to turn into a big fish. That's who they want. But I hope she gets what is coming to her. But like the old saying goes, ain't no fool like an old fool. Until next time, this is your guy, Mr. Educator, Mr. Communicator, Mr. Free Thinker. Subscribe, share, and like to keep me rocking on the mic. Have a good night. Understand you soon, it won't be long. Keep on, keep running.